Tomorrow evening, over 50 young people from all over Ireland will work with a professional artistic team from London's West End and Scotland to stage a production of Oliver in the Waterside Theatre. The performing arts charity Music Theatre for Youth is the company making this all happen, with the help, as it happens, of the Arts Council and Translink, which means that I get to interview a man that I'm usually round about lawsuit cases and bus passes. Alan Young is here from Translink, and Jenny Cook is the CEO of Music Theatre for Youth. Good afternoon to you both. Alan, tell me first, I mean, Jenny, you'll have all the heart of the machine, so to speak, but why did Translink get involved, Alan?
Well, it's basically the Theatre for Youth developing as basically through the School Safety Challenge. We were involved with them for a while, and they decided to sort of take this further. That was a real safety drama competition, and these people were put on an excellent show, and we decided to take it further. And I've seen it as a natural fit, obviously, with the City of Culture coming in 2013, and basically over in the Waterside there. It's an excellent theatre, and obviously the connection with ourselves being one of the hubs of entertainment here in the Northwest.
Well, absolutely. Maybe some of the, I don't know, maybe the drivers all getting tickets to go. I don't know, but I mean, it's lovely.
Well, I'll talk to Jenny about that later.
So. Jenny, tell me more about the organisation and indeed what's brought us to this performance.
Well, 2005, the organisation was set up by myself and Vernon Mind, who was Professor of Opera and Music Theatre at Gothenburg University in Sweden. And in fact, this is sort of full circle. We started with Oliver in a weekend and Stranmillers University College in Belfast with 80 young people, and we staged the full production in a weekend.
Ambitious.
Ambitious, yes. We've since done 16 musicals in a weekend across Northern Ireland, and it's now All Ireland, so we have an All Ireland cast here for tomorrow night, all aged between 11 and 15. So it's amazing what this international team can do in a very short time scale.
Music Theatre for Youth. Isn't it funny, because theatrical communities, I think you thrive on that kind of pressure to make it happen. Of course, the show must go on, but isn't it funny how sometimes that kind of pressure will yield creativity?
Well, it's interesting, actually, because there's never a script on stage. They learn all the lines in that time scale, and we often used to ask each other, Vernon and I, if we gave them longer, would it be any better?
No.
And actually, it isn't. They rise to the occasion, these young people, and the adrenaline kicks in, and they're so talented, and with the right artistic team, you get a fabulous showcase.
There's a whole gang of them here. Have you learned your lines, by the way?
Yeah.
Do you all know? No fluffs. No, there better not be fluffs. Let's have a little bit of music. Guys, you want one of you set this up, because we have a young singer here who's just been rehearsing there a moment ago, and he's something to listen to, young Ollie. Jenny, set this piece up for us. What are we going to hear here?
We're going to hear Where Is Love, which is the flagship, I think, of Oliver. There are actually four Olivers in this production, and Ollie, who's here with us today, is singing Where Is Love for us.
Young Ollie Havlin. Take it away, guys.
Where is love? Does it fall from skies above? Is it underneath the willow tree that I've been dreaming of? Where is she? Close my eyes to see. Will I ever know the sweet hello that's meant for only me? Who can say where she may hide? Must I travel far and wide till I am beside someone who I can mean something to? Where is love? Who can say where she may hide? Must I travel?
That's lovely. There's something very disarming and sweet about a young man that stands up and sings. They go, Ollie, tell us a wee bit about yourself and how you first came to singing and a little more about yourself.
Well, I'm just 11 years old and my brother does singing and I look up to him, and so I just thought I'd give it a try, really.
Yeah. And how do you, I mean, getting used to your voice and singing, has that been an easy thing? I mean, how do you approach your singing?
Well, you just gotta go for it, really. It's all in the tummy.
Yeah, that's the whole thing about what do singers call that, Jenny?
Diaphragm.
The diaphragm. So you're thinking about your diaphragm at 11 years old?
Yeah.
Yeah. Jenny, just lovely, isn't it? I mean, it's totally disarming.
I tell you, it really engages me, and to see them all working so hard, which they've done this week, to deliver what they're going to tomorrow, and I think they're all so talented.
Alex is here, Ben's here, Alex Hull, yeah. Ben Redden and Saoirse Rafferty. You guys, no, so where do you guys come in? What's your thing? Where are you coming in here? Alex, what's your role?
I'm in the chorus, but it's still really hard to learn everything.
So. Have you got it all done? Because he had no notes there. So if he can do that, you guys can do the chorus, right? What about you, Saoirse? What are you involved with?
Well, I'm playing Charlotte, and this is my third year in 94th. And some years you'll get the lead role, and some years you won't. But everyone just puts in the same amount of work, so.
So I assume you guys have seen the film. I mean, people my age were kind of brought up. There's Oliver. I mean, have you other versions of Oliver in your head when you come to the stage?
Well, some people's actually been in it before and some people's just watched the film, but everyone has seen it, and it's just a really good musical and it's a really good choice.
So. Something about it as well. Obviously, it's a child's story as well. Ben, what are you doing?
Well, I am playing the part of the Artful Dodger.
Right.
And this is my second year at MT for Youth, and I've thoroughly enjoyed being part of the project.
So you're the pickpocket?
Yep.
So I need to put my mobile phone. Can you pickpocket? Have you had to train to be a pickpocket? Are you any good?
No, not in real life, obviously.
You have to say that. What about it, guys? I mean, what for you is the thrill of this? Because clearly you could be doing 1,000 other things on iPads and, like, you know, the stereotype about people your age, you're all stuck on the sofa watching TV and Celebrity Big Brother. Why are you in this here? So what's the buzz?
Well, it's something that I really, really enjoy. And if I didn't like it, I wouldn't be here. It's just something that I love to do. And that's why I've been here for 3 years and running. And I just love it.
Alex, what about you?
I've been dancing since I was small. So I just always love performing.
What is that about, though? What is the love about?
I
tell you, you know, standing up in front of me, I get very nervous sometimes, even, you know, when nobody can see you on the radio. But I always find it very difficult to walk onto a stage and do anything because you're kind of being looked at and stuff. But what's the buzz about for you?
I don't really know. It's more the adrenaline that keeps me going through it.
Maybe so. Ben, any thoughts on that?
Well, I've been into music theatre since a very young age, and I just one of my favourite things to do. And it's just the thrill of performing in front of an audience, and it's just really good.
You're making yourself sound about 50. You're only what age are you now? You're still very young, aren't you?
I'm 12.
Fantastic. I should say Paul Smith was accompanying on piano there when young Ollie was singing. Alan, what about it?
This is the first I've seen it in action. I'm actually gobsmacked. I mean, Ollie's just amazing. I mean, they're all amazing, but I mean, as I say, just to see it and hear it live, I mean, I can see quite clearly why we're getting involved. I mean, it's to encourage, obviously, young people, I guess, to perform, and it appeals to our passenger sort of makeup, you know, the younger people coming through. We want to appeal to all sorts of people.
And Jenny, we're very proud, you know, even this last half generation, to see proper creative spaces coming up through the town. I mean, the Playhouse has been there, we've got our Millennium Forum, Waterside Theatre. What a wonderful space when it's used to its capacity.
Like, we're delighted to be in Derry again, because again, we started in Derry in the Millennium Forum, and we're working with Foyleview Special School, have been for the last 2 years, working towards a piece for next year with the autistic kids, and some of them are hugely talented. Like, you probably know them, they have their own rock band.
Absolutely, they've been in here rocking out.
Absolutely, and we're also working with the Playhouse and also the Waterside. Right. So, you know, it's about giving everybody a chance. We've done a project in Strabane with the Alley Theatre, and lots of young people have come through from that and work with us in Belfast as well.
The wee band, I think, the wee band, you know, was called The Planting.
Yeah.
Jenny, you're not a Derry woman.
I am County Derry.
Oh, you're County Derry?
Yeah, I'm County Derry. I'm originally from Coleraine.
But you've been away, I ask you that because I wonder how you see it, maybe with a visitor's eyes, coming back to your native county.
I love Derry. I love coming here, and we get such a warm welcome from everybody here. here, and it's very special, and we're delighted to be back sort of for the next 2 to 3 years.
And what, in the corridors of culture, what are people saying about next year?
Well, I don't know at the moment. We're just hoping that we will be able to do something with Foyle View. We're working towards it anyway, and hopefully. And we would love to do something with the Playhouse and the Waterside as well. This is our sort of chance to do something with the Waterside, with Oliver tomorrow. And then with the older ones, maybe do something sort of site-specific. I know Northern Ireland Opera have been here, and we would like to do something similar with an All-Ireland cast with music theatre. And I can't tell you any more than that, but that is what I'm trying to do. With the most talented from across Ireland.
Well, I tell you what, getting young people up to the Rocksters and creativity and crack is time well spent, I think. Just Jenny, when you're here tomorrow, give people times and details.
Well, 2 o'clock matinee tomorrow at the Waterside. They can get tickets through the Waterside Theatre, and tomorrow evening at 7:30 at the Waterside Theatre, and I can guarantee you they will get one heck of a showcase.
Okay, kids, thanks for coming in. Kids, I mean, they're young adults, I should say. Ollie, you're a treat, my friend. Thank you for singing.
Thank you.
Lovely, lovely, lovely stuff there. And Alan from Transic. I don't know why I'm humoured. Sure, I don't know what a man from the bus is, but I just think it's great that you get that sort of cultural, you know, cross pollination, if you can call it that.
I mean, as I say, it's been a great, great working relationship so far. Yeah. And as I say, this is the first time we've been involved locally here in Derry, and we see it as sort of going from strength to strength, and who knows what's round the corner.
Absolutely. Well, we'll keep across it, and thanks all for popping in today. Alan Young there from Translink. Jenny Cook, the founder and CEO of Music Theatre for Youth, and the young people there, Alex, Ben and Saoirse, and young Ollie Havlin, maybe a young name worth keeping in mind there. Paul Smith accompanying on guitar, on keys there as well. The next story's about guitars. I'm way ahead of myself. 7126 522, that's our number.
BBC Radio Foyle with Mark Patterson.